Hey guys, I'm Rob and you're watching Stay Inspired. So for this episode, well, what I wanted to do was go back and do another character design session with this program that I've created, which has got banks of tons of character types, sort of descriptions. And as before, we're just going to use the same rule, one click and I'm stuck with whatever I get. So let's have a bit of fun and hopefully get a really cool character. So, here we go. Today, I will be designing a steampunk assassin who is depressed. Okay, that's an interesting one, but I'm sure we can make this work.
To start the design, I knew almost immediately that the depression should come from the profession, so that the character was feeling a remorse about all the people they had killed. That would maybe make the easiest link between the two. So I started playing with some designs of people looking really sad and really depressed, and tried a couple of different genders, guys and girls. Turned out that the girl one in the corner with the gun against her head sort of carried the most emotion, and whilst the guys looked cool with their gas mask helmets or their big goggles, the women's faces were able to convey a bit more emotion. And I thought it would might work a little bit better to do it that way. In the end, I was trying to establish all three themes in one design. I thought I did well with the steampunk and the depression, but the assassin didn't really come through, so luckily I actually had a chance to sleep on this design. I came back and I decided to add some elements from the Assassin's Creed franchise, the games. So in the final design, I actually added hidden blades, little throwing knives, and even the Assassin's Creed belt buckle, just so that there was a really strong assassin element, a really strong steampunk element, and that really strong sort of suicidal depressed element. The pose was strong, and after refining the initial sketches, I was really happy with the direction it was going in, so I just went from there. When it got to the inking stage, I realised I was quite stuck on a colour palette. I couldn't really decide what would work best with her sort of with her clothing. So what I ended up doing was scanning in the finished ink drawing and printing off a template of about six mini drawings. And with that, I was able to just have a little play around, testing out some colours that I thought might work, and then just some random ones just to see what they might look like. And after my sixth or seventh design, I found the one that I was really happy with. After I was happy with the colours I had chosen, it was just a case of trying to make it as clean as possible. Had some really nice gradients with the alcoholic markers, and try and bring the piece to life as best I could. I think overall this piece from start to finish took maybe 4 or 5 hours, but I was really happy with the final result. It's very bright. Okay, that's a bit better. So, yeah, that was the final piece. You know, it's strange because I've clicked on the randomizer a few times, not when I'm doing drawing anything, just to see what it comes up with, and you know, you have a think about what that might look like. And I find myself skipping a lot of them because it's like there's one that I know I want to do, but I don't know what that is. And it's strange because when I first got depressed Steampunk Assassin, I kind of thought, oh, I'm not sure if I want to do that one, but there would be no other point where I would draw that, and I'm really glad I did, because I actually really like the result, and it's different, and it's cool. So I think these design sessions are going to be fun. I think you need to break out of your comfort zone a little bit, and kind of get surprised with what you might come up with. So yeah, I really hope you enjoy this video. Remember to like and subscribe, and let me know what you think. Okay, and until next time, stay inspired.